Steak alone cannot subdue a starving stomach. An appetite comes with eating. Carl wondered how long he would have to endure this skin-stinging cold. The worst parking job ever. Who was Carl to judge, though? It may be customary to park like that around these parts, or not. The store and its surroundings still held their secrets, and he didn't like to miss out. It was a typical shack, just like the ones you hear about in Quebecois legends. Local lumberjacks used it to rest and twice a day heat up their pea soup. Who quits a game one step away from victory? Without a single window to brighten things up, the inside of the cabin was almost pitch black. Beware of close encounters of knee and furniture. Solitaire, a card game only hermits can truly enjoy. Carl felt depressed at the thought of playing this. Everything was set up for a well-deserved snack. It seemed like the place hadn't been empty for long, but without knowing exactly why, Carl had the feeling no one was coming back anytime soon. This cabin doesn't look like a bunkhouse, especially with the missing stove and chimney. Carl was intrigued at the secrets possibly hidden here. Thank you. Carl wondered how long he would have to endure this skin. Stinging cold. A wintry atmosphere surrounded the house. The soundlessness of the area suggested it was empty. When finding a boot, one wonders what became of the foot. When finding a boot, one wonders what became of the foot. The key, which seemed to be meant for a padlock, bore an inscription reading Clouté et Fils. A company name. Better keep an eye open. Businesses weren't exactly numerous around these parts. Money in a jar. What a shame. Carl would have loved cookies. Hay stub for some undoubtedly harsh lumberjack work. Alexandre Blais felled trees and chopped woods for Cloutier et Fils.